Good morning. Welcome to KTV. I'm Kalina. Today is Tuesday, February 23rd, 2021. It is National Banana Bread Day. It is a day one. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now, a quick message from Mr. Hayes.
Good morning and buenos dias, Clippers. This morning, you may notice that our flag is flying at half staff. That is because we are honoring and paying tribute to a really horrific number in the United States that we've reached with the pandemic of 500,000 Americans who have now lost their lives to COVID-19. So please join me in taking a moment of silence to remember. Thank you very much. And it's important as we continue to battle the pandemic and understand where we are, that we continue to practice wearing our mask all the time, practicing physical distancing, trying to keep that 6 feet of separation between us and other people at all times. And yet we realize how difficult that is, especially in the hallways, but really ask you to make a concerted effort to try to keep that 6 feet distance as much as possible and whenever you can. And by continually wash our hands and sanitize our hands and surfaces. Thank you very much, everyone. Have a great day.
Now to Declan with today's Black History Month biography.
Under 5 decades as a recording artist, Aretha Franklin, the undisputed queen of soul, became a music legend. Aretha Franklin was born in Memphis, Tennessee on March 25th, 1942. Her family soon relocated to Detroit, Michigan, where her father, Reverend Church, and became a minister at the New Bethel Baptist Church. Reverend Franklin was a prominent gospel performer in his own right, and career exposed his daughter to gospel and soul music, and to civil rights leaders such as Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., and contemporary or others such as Smokey Robertson, Sam Cooke, Clara Ward, and Bobby Blue Bland. Now back to Kalina with the rest of today's news.
Good morning, Clippers. Beginning this week, we are going to recognize students for demonstrating the school-wide behavioral expectations: respectful, responsible, reliable, and safe. Clinger Middle School is filled with students who are demonstrating these expectations daily. Staff members are going to submit virtual tickets for students. They are looking for 3 things. 1, that they are able to see your face in class, either in the classroom or on the meet. 2, you are working in the classroom. Your work is out, your pencil is out, and you are working on what has been asked. At home, you are on the right screen and are answering the teacher on GoGuardian. You are completing assignments. 3, that you are sharing your voice in class, either out loud or in the chat, or privately via GoGuardian. Answering questions, asking questions, sharing information, or adding on is what someone else said. Students recognized will be entered into a raffle, and the winners will be announced at the end of the week. Prizes will be given to the raffle winners. Show off your kindness along with demonstrating being respectful, responsible, reliable, and safe. Have fun. Attention all actors. There will be a musical meeting on Wednesday, February 24th at 1:15. The link is on Google Classroom page. The sixth grade book club will hold our final discussion of the book Refugee by Alan Gratz on Wednesday, February 24th at 2:30. Please contact Ms. Laverty for the meet code. Attention concert choir members. There will be a virtual rehearsal today at 3 p.m. Please let Ms. Tyson know if you cannot attend. Attention student council members. Our next meeting will be on Wednesday, February 24th at 12:30 to 1:15 p.m. Please bring your lunch and be prepared to discuss a plethora of topics. Bring a friend who is interested in helping us. The link for the meet is on Canvas as always. See you then. Attention students. The GSA, Gender Sexuality Alliance, will be meeting on Wednesday, February 24th at 3 p.m. virtually. If you have any questions or would like to join us for our meeting, you can reach out to Ms. Blumenthal by email or by phone. Remember to email Ms. Blumenthal if you are interested in attending, and she will send you to the Google Meet invite. Do you have any gently used children's books? The Klinger Builders Club is now accepting donations to benefit our community. There is no better way to celebrate Read Across America Week than to give to books to others in need. All you have to do is place your gently used books in either Ms. Salenzi's room or with Mr. Spires in the lobby. Thank you very much for your support. Here's Declan with today's random fact.
Thank you. Dragonflies have 6 legs but cannot walk. That's today's random fact. Now back to you.
Thank you. And now for today's joke of the day.
What's the Tooth Fairy's favorite dance? The floss.
I thought it was watch me nay nay.
Thank you, Sean Dillon, for that joke. If you think you have a funny joke that can be told on KTV, email us at ktv@centennialsd.org. Make sure you include your name. We may use it on air. That was today's joke of the day. Now back to you.
Thank you. Here are today's Klinger birthdays.
Thank you. Happy Klinger birthday to Avery Young. That's today's birthdays. Back to you.
Thank you. And now for the whole KTV News crew, I'm Kalina. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day.